Saint, how you doing? You doing all right? What's wrong? Your what? Your throat? What's the problem with your throat? Well, I'm not going to make you do a lot of talking this morning, but I do need to get a hold of that letter real quick because this has been on my heart. By the way, where's your sidekick? Your sidekick not here today?
I had to make a change.
You had to make a change? What kind of change?
I had to start delivering.
Oh, my goodness alive. Well, look, you better look after that little sidekick of yours. You hear? We've grown close to that sidekick.
Okay.
All right, well, Saint, I appreciate this, and you go take care of your throat, all right?
Okay.
And I appreciate this so much. In 1 Corinthians 15 and 51, the Bible says Paul was writing to the church at Corinth, and this is what he said. He said, "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed." I've read that scripture I don't know how many times. I've heard it at I don't know how many funerals. And when I heard it this week, the Lord just reaffirmed something that I knew, but I took it for granted. And that is that one day, every person that is a believer, everybody say, believer. That's real important for you to know. I'm talking about believers. Everyone that is a believer or has been a believer, regardless of whether they're in the ground and a funeral's been had for them or they're still living, it doesn't matter if they died crippled, if they died with a broken heart, if they died bankrupt, if they died sick, if they died confused or feeling alone or unloved. Yes, I'm talking about believers now. It doesn't matter, because before you get to heaven, I'm going to be real quick because I'm tempted to preach, okay? You know what happens when I get into that mode. But before you get to heaven, before you spend any time talking to grandma, mama, daddy, anybody else you love, you care about, before you walk on those golden streets, before you just look at all the beautiful scenery that is there, something's got to happen. You got to be changed. You got to be made heaven proof. Right now, nobody in here, I don't care how good you think you are, you ain't heaven proof. You'll crumble. You won't even get past the first inch of the atmosphere. But when Jesus calls the dead, or he catches those that are still alive and remains, the first thing that's got to happen, all those things about you, all the scars as a Christian, all the bruises, all the hurts, all the disappointment in churches, in preachers, in ministries, all the things that you just wished you didn't have to deal with on this earth, gonna be changed. Gonna be gone. All the crime that you've done, all of it's going to be gone because you're going to be changed. Even the things about you that you don't like, it's going to all be changed. You know what? You hear about change so much now. You hear people that's running for office talking about change. When we go to the skating ring on Monday nights, I hear children talking about change. You hear change, 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 change. But I'm talking about a real change. I ain't even got to heaven yet, okay? We just talking about being changed. So, Paul said, it's all a mystery. It's hard to really understand it. It's hard to even figure out. You mean the way I woke up limping and hurting, or my knee was locked up on me, or my eyes were watering, or my chest is still hurting because what happened Friday at work? Honey, gone. The problems I've been gone. I'm telling you, and when you get to heaven, that's why the Lord's going to have to make everybody shut up and be quiet for 30 minutes. You're going to be so elated when you get there. You're going to be so electrified when you get there, because what? Now, when I died, that was there. It's gone now. I'm going to hush, because you know what? I start thinking about all that stuff. I know people that's got some problems. They're going to be gone. I know some of you that has some things that you would love to change. Amen?
Amen, brother. Amen. You tell it, brother.
Grumpy.
How you doing, brother?
There's one thing I don't want to change. Now, Grumpy, I'm talking about change, but there's one thing I don't want to change.
What's that, brother?
I don't want you to ever change being my friend. You hear me?
That's right. That's right, brother.
And
you
Grumpy,
tell it.
Until that day happens, we're just going to keep pressing on, and we're going to keep trusting Jesus, okay?
That's right.
And hey, we're going to talk to him right now and tell him about all these things that we're still dealing with, because the Lord can heal us. He can touch us. He can help us now. And I'm wondering, what have you got? You got something that you want us to pray about today?
Yeah, I got a couple things there. I want us to be praying for the Lewis family.
Lewis family.
Yeah, it's the Lewis family. And I would like everybody to please continue praying for Junebug's nephew's little baby,
right.
Caitlin. It's been an improvement. Prayer's going a long way. Everybody just keep on praying.
We're going to keep praying for Junebug's nephew and his baby. We're going to really pray for that family, okay?
That's right. Prayer goes a long way.
Well, I want you to do something. I want you to pray for us, okay?
I sure will.
All right. You remember the church, we got a lot of people that's sick, a lot of people that needs for the Lord to move in a mighty way, and you just remember us, okay?
I sure will, brother.
We shall be changed. We shall be changed. Changed from mortal to
I just still can't help but wondering and worrying and I don't know.
Hey, how y'all doing?
How you doing, Pastor?
Good to see y'all this morning.
Good morning.
Good to see you. What y'all been up to?
I ain't running no race.
Well, you should be running a race.
We all should. Run a race with this bad leg.
Yeah, but there's another race we need to be running.
And which one would that be?
And with that leg there, it ain't going to be like that forever.
That's what I was just telling her. One day Jesus is going to straighten this old
one of these days, it's going to be changed.
Yep.
And hey, they're going to change it in the twinkling of an eye.
He might need to talk to her.
What?
She's down, depressed, and brokenhearted.
Oh, when that time comes, she's going to be changed too.
That's what I tried to tell her, but she's down.
Goody buggy.
Look at the baby sleeping.
Goody buggy.
You want to have a seat? Sure. That's fine. Let the lady sit here for a minute with the baby. I know
he's good. Thank
you. Yeah, they say I do
good
work.
Okay, sir, how are you today? I'm sorry.
I'm doing all right. How you doing?
Just so fabulous. You do not, you care for some fruit?
I can't half understand him because he talks some kind of French or something.
Let me give you some very good apple frame apple from me. Love this apple right here. What about you, the mom? Will you care for some fruit?
Sure.
Today is free. Louise, you give away free fruit today.
Free? All
free
right.
Today. God free. Is so good to me. I have to be good. There you go.
Thank you.
Guys, a man of the clock, my praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful to meet a man of the clock.
I've heard about you.
Oh, Reverend, dear Reverend, I hope you heard Louise's good things.
Louise, you give everything.
Oh, no, he don't give everything. I hope you hear.
Today.
Well, he gave a lot, but I don't know about everything now. The Reverend, but I have to give you a peace offering because you're the man of the cloth.
What? I like bananas.
Oh, you like bananas?
I like bananas.
Reverend, you like bananas? This is the best banana. I tell you what. You take this banana, you eat this banana, you have any left, make your little banana pudding. Oh, Louis, you love to put the banana pudding. And think about it, Reverend.
Oh, preachers love banana pudding.
I have heard that. I really have heard that.
That's right.
Preachers like the banana pudding. Hey, Reverend,
can you spare one more?
For the man of the Lord, no problem.
Thank you
very much.
Hey, you got some chicken on that buggy? Because I heard preachers like chicken too.
The Reverend, we don't have no chicken for the Reverend, but we have plenty of fruit.
Chicken today.
Hey, Mr. Louise, I've been meaning to ask you.
What's your name, Buggy?
Why is this red?
Junior
Buggy. What
are
you calling red for?
Junior Buggy, I'm so glad. Hey, son, how you doing? You care for something? Sure. I tell you, Junior Buggy, the reason the cart is red, it's wonderful that you asked me that because when I was getting my cartoon for the first time, Luigi think, I can't leave it plain. I can't leave my cartoon plain. So the Lord let it on my heart. Luigi, why don't you just paint your cartoon red? And I said, God, why I paint my cartoon red for? He says, because anytime you look at that red cart, you think about the blood of Jesus. And when you think about the blood of Jesus, you think about how Jesus died. He shed his blood for man, so man could be saved forevermore. Junior, do you know that Jesus has shed his blood for you too?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes,
well,
sir.
Well, praise God for that. Junior, yes. Just for you knowing that, I give you something off of the card.
All right.
I was wondering why it was red. Every time I've ever seen one, it's just been old wood, not painted or nothing.
Well,
but that sure is pretty.
Well, Mr. Jackie, that's it. Because every day when I'm doing the work that I have to do with my hands, I look, red cart. What color of the shirt am I wearing there, Mr. Jackie?
It looks like crimson red.
Red, because it reminds me of how much Jesus loved me enough to die for my sins. And Luigi is so thankful he dedicated his life, his cart, even his clothing to Jesus, which is so good.
Amen. That's a good testimony. How's Junebug been working out for you?
Well, Mr. Jackie, I need to talk to you about Junibuggy, because Junibuggy do more than Luigi ever think.
What?
He's...
How did you manage that?
I don't know. I just thought he was so good.
Maybe I need to paint these here things red.
Well, I don't know. But I do know this, Mr. Jackie. Junibuggy do so good. I need him for one more week. Because I run into a bean. A bind? He's got a bean to bind?
A what?
A bind. I run into a bind.
A bind.
A bind.
I run into a bind. Of course I call it a bind. I call it a bean, I don't know.
A bean vine?
It's a hard time for me. And what happened when I went to the Cedarville? All of my things that I was going to move back here and everything, I just could not get it all done in 1 week. And so I thinking, God, help your child. How can I do this, Lord? I promise to do your work in the Cedar Grove, in the move to the Cedar Grove.
Yes.
I don't know how to do this, God. You're going to have to help the Luigi. God said, I saw Mr. Jackie can just fire Junibuggy one more week.
I don't mind. You've been so nice and helpful. I don't mind helping you out and lending you my Junibug.
Well, if you let the Luigi buy the Junibuggy, I tell you what, I'll give you my grip.
I need grapes. I'm all out. I sold slap out of them.
Are you serious?
Serious as a heart attack?
Oh, my God. He supplied the needle, Mr. Jackie, with the grapes.
Yes.
Hey, man, I tell you what. Now.
What you got?
Jackie,
you got?
This grapes right here, my mama Noy grew these grapes a long time ago. She fertilized mama Noy, no grapes like nobody's business.
Mm-hmm.
These grapes are another grapes because Mama Noy prayed for these grapes. That's why they look so good, make the best grape juice. Possibly why other than God's touch why you sell so many. So I give you these grapes.
I appreciate it.
Miss Jackie, if you'll excuse me, I have to. There's a young man. I told God, like you and your work, we dedicate what I do to the Lord. There's a young man, I believe a homeless man.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yep.
And Mr. Louise.
What's the Junibuggy?
Yes. I need to go back down to the barn. The hood I went down, I got last week.
Yes,
I'm going to go down there and see if they got another one in, okay?
Okay, Junibug.
You want me to take you?
Two hands, get lots of work done.
Okay, I'll take care of this, okay?
Okay, wait a minute. Hold that just a second.
Okay, okay.
Because God has laid this on my heart. There's a young man. Okay, Junibug.
Okay.
Be real careful.
You do a good job this week.
That's right. I always do. You just going to appreciate
you
it.
The Junibuggy. Now, Mr. Jackie, I go to...
She just don't know good help when she sees.
Over in the woods. Got this letter on my heart. I seen him early this morning. Looked like he don't have a home. Looked like he was looking for some food. God said, I bless you with fruits. I bless you with vegetables. Luigi, you need to be God's hands and God's feet.
That's right.
I'm going to see this man to see if I can be a blessing.
That's a blessing. I'm going to talk to this lady and this pretty little baby boy just a minute. Okay.
Son, before Luigi go, would you like a lemon? Make some good lemon juice. Tell your mother to make you some lemon juice, best lemon juice in the world.
Thank you for the crepes.
Okay, I'll see you later.
See you.
Bye, you fine folks.
Hey, Minor John, is that hoe came in yet?
How you doing?
No, they ain't come in yet. I'm going to have to change companies. So they're getting slack. I can't keep on working like this. It's not here.
Okay, well, I'll check with you later on then.
You know what? The Lord Jesus Christ lay it on my heart. He says, man over in woods, very hungry, don't have no home. We share your goodness with him.
I don't have any money.
My brother, Vision. A basket from the hands of Jesus Christ. He give you all this for free. Eat, enjoy. It's your son.
Thank you. Thank you.
Luigi pray for you too. God bless you, son.
You like them there grapes, Reverend? They good. Ooh, they good. I better quit eating them. I ain't gonna have nothing to steal. You hold on to that now. Let me see this pretty little baby. Hey.
How's that little fella doing?
He's doing all right.
You know what? He has grown like a little weed since last time I saw him. Where you been? I saw you coming out of the doctor's office the other day. How's he doing?
Well,
he's doing good.
He's not doing too good. I mean, he seems to be healthy and everything, but the doctor said that he's not developing like he should, and he'll never be able to walk.
He'll never walk?
No, never walk. He'll never be able to run and play or go to school.
Bless his heart.
Let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you what the Bible says. There'll come a day, if he lives to be 15 years old or 30 years old or 50 years old, when Jesus Christ comes back and he takes us up, there'll be a change. It will change in the twinkling of an eye.
That's right. Amen.
And when we change in the twinkling of an eye, and this is what I can imagine. When I walk up to the pearly gates, and them gates swing open wide, and I take that first step into the pearly gates, and I think I'm going to take my shoes off.
You think so?
Because it's going to be streets of gold. I'm going to be walking on them streets of gold.
That's right.
But when I go walking down them streets of gold, no matter whether it's somebody that can't walk, he's going to walk. He's going to be just like, he can walk better than you and me.
That's right. We'll have a new body.
I talked to a fella this morning. He was crippled with his leg. If he's living right, he's going to change in the twinkling of an eye. And when he walks in there, he's going to walk just as good as me and you can walk.
He sure is. When the Lord comes for him, we're going to be changed instantly before we even make it up there. We're going to have a new body before we even get there.
Don't worry about this little boy. Just bring him up the way you should bring him up. He's going to be okay. I promise you.
It's just hard, you know.
Jesus will take care of him.
He'll be changed one day. You do your part, whether it's here on earth or it's up in heaven, he'll be changed.
I can't wait to see it, because right now my heart hurts so bad.
He's a special little boy.
I know you're upset.
He's special.
He is. He's so pretty. I know you ain't supposed to say boys are pretty, but I declare he's pretty.
Thank you. Thank you, Miss Jackie.
You ever heard that song? You can.
Miss Jackie! Miss Jackie!
Hey, Grandpa.
Can you hear me? You doing all right?
I can hear you mighty fine.
Well, that's good. My throats have been giving me a lot of problems here lately. Miss Jackie, I need to ask you a favor if I can.
All right.
I need for you to be praying for me because me and Sis, we're having to make a decision about the old home place here.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what to do. Somebody's wanting this land, and they want it more than we've got money to try to defend it or stay here.
Oh, you know,
I don't know what to do, Miss Jackie, and I really, really, really need some prayers.
All right. Well, the preacher's here with me, and we'll join together and have prayer, because I know you've been living up there a long time.
Well, I have, and I know it ain't much. But it's what God gave me, and I trust the Lord, and I know the Lord can make it all right.
That's right.
But I get worried sometimes. You know, it seems like one battle after another, and I'm gonna stay on my feet for God. But you know, I'm just looking forward to the day when I don't have to worry about all these things anymore. It just seems like the devil likes to try to throw one ball after another and hit us, and I don't know what to do, but I do know this. One day, when Jesus calls me home, hallelujah, I'm going to be changed and it won't be none of this share mess. So be praying for me because it really gets me down, would you?
I will, Grandpa.
Thank you so much, Reverend. I appreciate your prayers, too, as well. Y'all just agree together.
We'll be praying for you.
I appreciate it so much.
Try not to worry. I know it's hard, but
well,
try
I'm gonna try not to.
I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
her newborn baby to her chest and sings to him a tender lullaby. Although he gently sleeps, he was born with special needs. She loves him so, but still it breaks her heart. It's hard to understand what we can't clearly see, but heaven will reveal life's mystery. On the other side of time, broken things are healed and empty things are filled as we stand in heaven's light. On the other side of time, it's more than just a dream. Children laugh and sing, and every heart is free. There's perfect peace on the other side of time. Some are like stars that brightly shine, but they only glisten for a while. A light fading in the dark, an unfinished work of art, and we'll never know just what might have been. Oh, but there's a distant place that's never known a tear. Skies are blue and rainbows never disappear. On the other side of time, broken things are healed and empty things are filled as we stand in heaven's light. On the other side of time, it's more than just a dream. Children laugh and sing, and every heart is free, and there's perfect peace on the other side of time. There's no guarantee that life won't be unfair, but the debt this life owes us all be settled there. On the other side of time, broken things are healed and empty things are filled as we stand in heaven's light. Oh, on the other side of time, it's more than just a dream. Children laugh and sing, and every heart is free. There's perfect peace on the other side of time. On the other side.